Decades passed. In the fabric of the 1940s, men stood as unequivocal masters of their own destinies. An era flavored by the return of men from the horrors of World War II was also a time of men fashioning their futures with grit, determination, and male-centric support systems. Fast forward to today, and the canvas of male identity appears drastically altered. So, what spurred this transformation? A tidal wave of change initiated by the rise of feminism and sexual identity politics in the mid-20th century appears to be a decisive factor. As a matter of consequence, men's behavior and societal roles underwent a dramatic evolution. More than a simple paradigm shift, this transformation has shaken the foundation of men's fraternity, empowerment, and self-identity. The net result? A disempowered male figure in contemporary society. Starting in the post-war period, as women transitioned from the role of wartime Rosie the Riveter to fully fledged members of the workforce, demands arose for integrated workspaces. Women's groups began a crusade for gender integration through activism and litigation. They pushed for the dismantling of men's gender-exclusive spaces, lobbying for co-ed areas that incorporated both genders. On the surface, this seemed a righteous endeavor for equality. But it bore implications far beyond the integration of genders in the public arena. It interrupted the long-standing chain of male-to-male socialization. Young men, who would traditionally be mentored and supported by older male peers through fraternal organizations, found their patriarchal support systems dwindling. The age-old tradition of men fostering the personal and professional growth of younger men, guiding them to master their destinies, was hampered. Simultaneously, the rise of sexual identity politics precipitated a parallel disintegration of men's societal power. This new political landscape crafted two primary sexual identity groups. The accepted group, purportedly useful to women, and the ostracized control group, deemed not useful to women. This duality of identity acted as a looming threat over men's heads, pushing them into a behavioral mold that conformed to women's expectations. Any deviation was met with the fear of association with the ostracized group. Men began to view one another not as allies but as potential threats, causing a fracture in the unity and support once intrinsic to male social groups. This political manufacturing of male identities, in which sex was portrayed as a man's primary identifier, further shattered the foundation of men's mutual support. The resultant societal structure had men grouped and judged primarily on the basis of their sexual identity. The brotherhood once shared was replaced by a culture of suspicion and alienation. Fast forward to the present, and the fallout from these shifts is painfully visible. Statistics paint a disheartening picture. Men are increasingly dropping out of the workforce, their positions being usurped by those they once mentored. Their societal roles, once defined by power and independence, are now marred by apprehension and uncertainty. For example, data from the Bureau of Labor Statistics shows a steady decline in male workforce participation. In 1950, the male labor force participation rate stood at a staggering 86.4%, while the same rate for 2020 fell to just 69.2%. Simultaneously, men are increasingly seen occupying positions of lesser power, diminishing their once dominant role in societal hierarchies. The transition from the 1940s to the present day represents more than just the passage of time. It marks the erosion of male power and identity, with men no longer the masters of their own destinies. The societal shifts instigated by feminism and sexual identity politics not only disrupted the balance of power but altered the very fabric of male identity and fraternity. As we navigate the intricacies of the 21st century, it becomes crucial to examine this evolution and its impact. The future, after all, is crafted by those who understand their past. It is imperative that we reassess the dynamics that have led us here, to ensure that every man, much like in the 1940s, can become the master of his own destiny.
that still remains the same through all this changing that still remains the same through all this changing world.
Thank you.
that still remains the same through all this changing this changing scene? Where is it taking us? What does it mean? As long as we're certain of each other, these changing times we rise above. We have no time for them. We have our love, and that still remains the same through all this changing world.
that still remains the same. Through all this changing
Much obliged, you hopped on board for this snazzy trip through American life in the 1940s and 1950s, all captured through nifty vintage photographs. If this flick's got your motor running, don't be a square. Click on that jolly bucket of bolts to subscribe to the channel for more top drawer content just like this. Yeah.